When we come to Him, we come to Him and say, Lord, I'm ready to die. I'm ready to die to this world and die to myself and die to everything around me. The world will try to trick you and deceive you, won't they? And say, what you really need is this. And they'll say, you need power. You need influence. You need fame. You need money. You need stuff. You need bigger this. The world will tell you that. And then you'll read about the people that have all that stuff. And they talk about how their life is so messed up because they're pursuing the wrong things. Our pursuit should be God and God's holiness in our life. Striving to please Him and to live for Him every day. Because God says that's where the riches are. The spiritual riches that He wants to pour out upon us. So we look at this list of six things that God wants to bless us with. The riches of knowing Him. And these six riches are the true riches from God. All these riches, they come by God's grace and they are for God's glory. These riches are here on this earth is only the beginning. There is much more to be on us, to be given to us in the future. That's what we learn from these riches in Christ. They're from God. They're from His grace. They're for His glory. And there's much more. There's much more out there. So the question is, do you know it? Have you surrendered? Are you in Christ? The Bible says the way we are in Christ is we have to deal with the sin in our life. Sin separates from God. The Bible says we need to repent of our sins. Turn away from it. And then we need to trust in Christ alone. Trust in Him. Make that decision in your life to surrender your all to Him. To be willing throughout your life to confess Him now as Lord and Savior of your life. And even be willing to be baptized into you. This picture of God cleansing you of all of your sins, going in there and coming up a new person in Christ. This picture, this symbol, this command from the Lord. He said, go there. All authority has been given to me, Jesus said. Go into all the world and make disciples, teaching them to obey all that I've commanded you, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Make disciples. Become a fully devoted follower, disciple of Jesus Christ. Never make that decision. God wants you to make that decision today. Today. Like last night, Lord, I saw some news from one of our friends who's been battling cancer. And she died yesterday. She's 39 years old. She's a husband and three children. Now, she knew the Lord. And I know where she is. And I know she's rejoicing. And I know there's no pain and suffering in her life. And my heart aches for her husband and her children because she's just 39 years old. That's young. None of us know a day or a time when our life will be over here on this earth. Part of living is dying. And we will all die unless He comes back again. So are you ready? Have you made a decision? Have you honestly, sincerely crossed the line and said, Lord, I'm all yours? If you haven't, and God's pulling and tugging in your heart today, then you need to make that decision. We're going to have a decision song. And we're going to sing that decision song. If you want to make a decision for Christ, then I encourage you to do that today. Let's pray for God to work in our church today. Lord, we just thank You for Your word and for Your truth. We thank You for the riches that we have in You, just how abundant they are and how wonderful they are. We sit here and we talk about it this morning, and you know me, Lord, I get all worked up about it and start jumping up and down and excited that You know us, that You can know us this way. And Lord, I just pray if there's anyone here today who's just not being honest and sincere with You, their heart's not open to You, just pray that Your Holy Spirit might work on them this morning to convict them of their need to be right with You, Lord. None of us know how long we've got. We need to get this one thing right. And I pray that today that we will all get this right. I know, Lord, there's some today that are doubting whether You're truly in their life or not. I pray that You would bring them some assurance, Lord. If they know You, if they don't know You, You will let them know today. and they will do business with you and come to know you. And I pray in Jesus' name, amen. Will you stand with me and we'll sing the decision of the song? We'll sing and we'll pray that the Lord will have His own way in our hearts and in our lives. Praise and glory and honor to you. In Jesus' name.